Is food discriminatory? In other words, are the foods you eat prejudiced towards you based on how your race, age, sex, or weight?
Take it from me, somebody with no credentials whatsoever on this controversial topic will tell you everything you want to know about food racism.
But first,
a word from our sponsors.
Milk.
Let me tell you something. I drink milk every single day. And I'm lactose intolerant. Which means you can drink milk every single day too. Anyway. Life can be unfair. But to be more specific, food is unfair. Why? Let's take a look. Here in my garage, we have one refrigerator. What's inside? Meats! All we have are meats! Meats are good for the muscles. However, do we look like we have muscles? Skinny! 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 Ugly! Oh wait, that's me. We eat so much meat, and yet we're still very so skinny. Why is that? Let me tell you. If we look on this chart, you can obviously tell that we have all one thing in common. We're all Asian! That must be it. Food is racist. What, you don't believe me? I'll show you. Noodles, rice, curry. What's the first thing that pops into your head? How delicious it is. What's the second thing then? Well, obviously it's gonna be people who south tacos, burritos, quesadillas. What's the second thing that pops into your mind? People south of the Great Wall of Trump. McDonald's. What's the second thing that comes into your head? People whose south is bigger than their north. Stereotypical, unethical, radical, racist. Food is indeed an evil entity.
Food is not just racist, it is also ageist. And yes, ageist is a word. It means age discrimination. Face it, we've all tried baby food before, and I must admit, it's not the greatest thing in the world. And if you've ever had old people food, it's basically the same thing, and still disgusting. But then there's the age gap in between that is food that stimulates the colon, adult food. That's good food. But what's the big deal? Sure, standard food is better than your average mashed peas. But that doesn't mean food is ageist.
That's wrong!
That's wrong!
Food is ageist!
Wanna know why? Let's go. Get in the car. I'm getting some ice cream. That's just it. It's natural that when we're of age, those adult foods taste better and baby foods taste worse. And if we become of older age, old people food becomes better. The science behind that is that food consciousness is still there.
Whatever do you mean, Mr. Smartass?
Whoa. Okay. Let me just take it back to health class. If we look back to freshman year, where we watched the film Super Size Me, we discovered that all foods were once living. All foods used to have a thinking process. Even when killed, that process is still there.
What exactly were in those thoughts? One word.
Umami.
Also known as
the fifth taste.
Such as, described as, characterized as
deliciousness.
The food itself actually chooses how it tastes. Not our taste buds, not the manufacturers, and not the complimentary products that go with it. The food itself decides whether you are worthy of flavor explosion.
How? Explain to me.
Okay. I tell you. I will tell you. Because I am conspiracist. I tell you every single detail. Because you are peasant. You are illiterate. And you are stupid. Alright. Okay. Here's where the ageism kicks in. Food decides the umami based on the age of the human who eats it. Well, that's because food has a weird fetish. Apparently, seeing the tongue is a turn-on for foods. Since this world is filled with disgusting people.
And all of them are men.
Once turned on, or whatever you want to call it, you just filthy animals. The flavor of the foods enhance or detracts based on your tongue. And the tongue relies heavily on the age of the person. Too young or too old won't satisfy those fetishes. Because, after all, even foods have dirty minds.
Good afternoon. Oh wait, it is still morning. Speaking of age, a long time ago, in the early ages of man, food has played a hefty role in the development of this specific discriminatory policy. That's right, genderism. Wait, sexism. There we go. How? Let's give you a real-world example. That's definitely true, and not made up at all. As you can see here, the world...
For your information, the world is round, not flat, just so you know.
I'm not interrupting you, am I? Good, because I hate to be rude and inconsiderate. Now where was I before I was so rudely interrupted? Oh yeah, now, as of statistical, non-made-up evidence, as of May 13th, 2018, there are about 7 million people in the world, and as of May 14th, 2018, the gender population is about 49.9% male and 49.9% female. Don't ask me about the remaining 0.2%. As we know, throughout history, males have been known to be taller than females. In fact, 99% of the male population that's of age 13 and up is taller than the average female person, which is 5'2". Napoleon's standard height, as you may recall.
That means that 3,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333,333, average female.
Why is it that males are taller than females? Is it because of bad genes? What foods men prefer over women's preferences? Will and testament of God? No, none. It's because food is sexist. Ever since Eve ate the forbidden fruit in the Garden of Eden, food has found it particularly rude that females have acted in such a terrible manner. And since then, food has been prejudiced towards women till this day, causing body disadvantages and awkward food habits. Blame it all.
Okay, so maybe you think we've gone a little too far to criticize food like this. After all men are created equal. We all criticize people on their race, gender, and age. Food is no different in those aspects. We get that. However, there's one aspect that must never be crossed by man, and yet food has crossed this aspect since the dawn of the dinosaurs.
Wait.
Yes, wait. Public enemy number one for insults, discrimination, and obesity. And yes, I'm going to say it. These people are also known as fat. Hate me all you want, but it's the truth.
Omae wa mou shindeiru. Nani?
Okay, so it's funny. In my family, we interpret fat
in a different way. By the way, no one in my family is fat. But we have a catchphrase called, I'm fat. For us, that means, I'm full. I made the mistake of saying that in front of very specific people. I got scolded at and would have gotten beat up, but fortunately for me, I stay in shape. I got out of there alive. Oh, but my lunch didn't though.
From that experience, how come I'm different? I probably eat the same amount as them, and yet I weigh half their size. I'll tell you why. It's because I...
You're wrong. Food is discriminatory against fat people because they find it funny. Observe. Grab the camera. Look, this person is fat.
I don't know, that kind of looks like printed me.
Like humans, food gets bored easily. So what's their sense of entertainment? Fattening the pig for slaughter.
I don't think that's how it works.
Despicable. If you think humans are bad, oh no, look at your bellies and tell me who's worse. Yeah. Humans or food?
I don't know, I'm pretty skinny, I guess.
Let's roll out, our work here is done.
Oh, wait. What's happening?
See my arms?
Wait, hold on. I'm just centering.
I wondered from that experience. How come I'm different?
Your glasses make it reflect kind of weird.
Is it better on or off? Well, it doesn't matter. You don't have glasses.
Go. Go.
Wait.
Yes, wait. Public enemy number one. Also known as fat. Hate me all you want. These people are also known as fat.
All right, oh my god. Oh my...
These people are also known as...
What?
Yes, wait. Public enemy number one for insult.
Boy! Ellis Cameo.
Milk.
Go, let's go.
Hello.
How's it going?
Hey, Nandy.
Let's go.